fertilization to full development, there'll be some unique functions, but generally a lot of overlap in these developmental molecules.
I think it's amazing that the brain is still capable of being plastic, even after it's arguably been fully developed.
Previously, we had thought that after development, our brains are just basically the same, that we're not creating new neurons in our brain. But neurogenesis is kind of this new concept of the fact that our brains are constantly changing throughout our lifetime.
We've just started the segment of the class that I am most interested in, which talks a lot about embryonic development, how the brain is changing and forming.
How do different neurons respond to different molecules depending on what stage of development you are?
I was really interested in the interplay between nature and nurture.
We're all seniors and we've all been in classes before and everyone's doing really, really cool research.
I actually did 1.5 years of research in an endocrinology lab on campus.
I work in a birdsong lab and I am starting looking at neurogenesis in the bird brain, and we're seeing how it's going to facilitate the acquisition of multiple song models.
We're looking at the role of glutamate transporters in behavior.
They're still trying to decide what they might do, and so having them in your research lab, seeing their aha moments when they just really catch on, is really rewarding.
And so you have to still go back in and do in vivo experiments to see how that molecule functions with others. And
that's what makes me really excited about neuroscience, because I want to be able to contribute to a new field where research is so dynamic and interpretations of results are constantly changing.